Revolt breaks all electric vehicle myths and barriers. Rahul Sharma is no ordinary man. He is the Harry Potter of EV world. Electric vehicle ke duniya ka jadugar. Look closely and you might see the magician's wand and the magician's cloak. Come the hour, come the man. The entire EV industry was wandering about without much leadership. Nobody was ready to put up their hands and be the leader. Tata Motors and Mahindra never wanted to be leaders in the electric vehicle industry. They were happy selling petrol cars and diesel SUVs. And on the other hand, the electric scooter industry was happy selling assembled hub motor vehicles brought from China. Till the launch of Revolt, electric vehicles were considered more expensive than petrol vehicles. Rahul Sharma has turned the vehicle industry upside down. Duniya hi hila diya petrol vehicles ke. Ab tak roj akbaar aur news channel pe aake roote the ye petrol vehicles banane wale. Ki direction nahi hai government ke, pata nahi kaun sa technology successful hoga. सब्सिडीज नहीं है, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर नहीं है, जीएसटी कम कर दो भाई, कई सारे बहाने बना के रोते हैं ये पेट्रोल और स्कूटर बनाने वाले, और ये बंदा 4,000 रुपए में बाइक बांट रहा है सबको. राहुल शर्मा हैज ट्रूली ब्रोकन ऑल इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल बैरियर्स. हियर आर द टॉप 10. दीज वर द टॉप 10 ईवी बैरियर्स दैट रिवोल्ट हैज ब्रोकन. One, EVs are expensive. Till now, electric vehicles were considered as an expensive vehicle. The best example is Tesla. Not only is the vehicle expensive, but its battery is also as expensive. Today, every guy who wants a bike and has rupees 4,000 in his pocket will purchase Revolt 400. The amount in US dollars is just 53 per month. Yes, it is $53 per month and not per day. Price has been the biggest barrier for electric vehicles because of the battery. When combined with 100 km range lithium ion batteries, the cost of the scooters went beyond rupees 1 lakh. Because of this, the price of electric scooters were always more than petrol scooters. Even the price of Revolt is around 1,50,000 rupees, while similar petrol bikes are available for around 90,000 rupees. But after paying this 90,000 rupees, petrol motorcycle owners have to pay more than rupees 3,000 for petrol every month. But in Revolt's case, they have to pay just rupees 4,000 every month without any down payment. This has to be one of the biggest marketing stories till date. Back in the year 2003, Reliance Infocom had tried a similar offer when they started to sell color screen mobile phones for just rupees 501. This was a time when the market price for such a mobile phone was more than rupees 5,000. Not surprisingly, Reliance Infocom got a lot of market literally overnight. 2. Waterproof guarantee. Then there were people who used to ask if electric bikes could be taken out in the rain or flooded streets. Rahul Sharma eased their fears by telling them not to take the bike where the water is above their nose, because up to the nose they are safe and beyond that it would be dangerous for them, not for the bike. EVs have limited range. Revolt has broken this myth and truly it has become an unlimited range bike. It is possible to ride 150 km, toss out the battery at a Revolt battery switching station, put in a fully charged battery and ride on. This is better than charging the battery because the drained battery will be warm and would need some time to cool down before charging it again. Switching battery saves a lot of such cooling down time and thus extends battery life. In a couple of years when Revolt has set up such stations all over India, you would be able to do this unlimited range rides and travel intercity faster and refuel quicker than petrol bikes. This was never possible with any EV in the world. Rahul Sharma has changed this. All electric vehicles sold in India can be charged from the house just like we charge our mobile phones. Still, the petrol vehicle manufacturers kept wailing, sobbing and weeping on every news channel about the so-called lack of infrastructure. If at all there was a lack of infrastructure, then it was a business opportunity which they never really understood. Nor were they interested to build it. They just wanted more and more concessions for building petrol and diesel vehicles. Most electric scooter manufacturers have found just two ways to charge a battery. First method was to charge the bike directly from the grid. Second method was to take the battery home to charge it. Revolt has two more methods to tackle the battery issue. Third solution of Revolt is to find a Revolt battery station near you on its smartphone app and write to it to switch the battery with a fully charged battery. Fourth solution of Revolt is if the battery is completely drained and you cannot make it to the battery switching station, then You can place an order on the app for a fully charged battery to be switched with your drained battery on the phone itself. This is kind of like the breakdown service. Four, electric vehicles are weak. People frequently ask, can electric vehicles climb flyovers or hilly areas? Due to the low power Chinese scooters, electric vehicles had a very bad name. Old Chinese scooters had multiple problems. All of them came with hub motors which were excellent on flat surfaces but performed badly on inclines. They had weak batteries. They had problems with the chargers and they had problems even with the body of the scooter which would break down or come apart after frequent use. Till date, only Ather and Revolt have mid-drive motors and both of them have enough torque to outperform any petrol two-wheelers of similar price and class. 5. Electric vehicles are silent and thus no fun. People complain that electric vehicles are no fun because of its silence, and bikers were used to the noise and they complained the loudest. Some even justified that this lack of noise would create more accidents because people would never hear an electric vehicle approaching or coming from behind and could be caught off guard. Rahul Sharma has shut these guys down by providing optional noise to the bike. Electric bikes cannot do stunts. Then there were those guys who smiled smugly and said EVs are good only for city riding and electric bikes cannot take rough roads or do stunts. But Revolt has shut these guys down. Till date, Revolt is the only electric two-wheeler in India with which you can perform stunts. 7. Electric vehicles are not bank loan friendly. There were those people who argued that electric vehicles do not have resale value, so they were not loan friendly. There is almost no demand for second-hand electric scooters, so electric vehicles were not considered loan friendly. MRP or My Revolt plan has changed all this. According to Rahul Sharma, no other supporting documents or income proof is necessary other than having an Aadhaar card to buy the Revolt bike. 8. 100% conversion to electric vehicles by 2050 is impossible. The entire petrol vehicle industry challenged the government that it is impossible to convert the existing petrol vehicle industry to electric vehicle industry by year 2050. Rahul Sharma's plans are big. He is following the get big or get out policy. The projected sale of electric two-wheelers in 2019 was just 72,000 vehicles. But due to the ease of use, increasing petrol cost, cheap recharging cost, FAME II concessions and the fall in lithium ion battery prices, electric scooters became very popular and achieved year 2020's target in the year 2019 itself. That is a 4 times increase of year 2018's sale. This year, Revolt is building capacity to manufacture 120,000 units per year. Beyond this, it is ready to expand even more. Year 2020 is going to be catastrophic for petrol two-wheeler industry. Revolt by itself will manufacture 120,000 bikes and the rest of the industry is going to churn out 280,000 scooters or motorcycles, taking the total sales to 4 lakh electric vehicles in the year 2020. Wait, there is more bad news for petrol two-wheelers. Other than that, 10 new electric motorcycles are expected to launch around the year 2020, and all of them are better than Revolt. All of them together will manufacture at least 100,000 electric two-wheelers. We at Plug & Karu have already mentioned that no two-wheeler company will recover beyond 2019 if they do not sell electric vehicles. So they too will have to sell electric vehicles. Jak maar ke bechna padega. So this will bring another 4 lakh electric two-wheelers to the market. Thus, the target of achieving 100% electric two-wheelers are completely possible by 2030, if not by 2025. So guys, don't get trapped by buying petrol two-wheelers, because the bikes bought today will not have any resale value after 5 to 6 years. 9. Electric vehicles come with low warranty period. Since most electric vehicles use lithium-ion batteries, their manufacturers were reluctant to give long warranty periods. Replacing complete battery packs would take away the profits. A battery is made up of many AA-sized lithium-ion cells. So if only the damaged cells were replaced, then it would be a viable business. Rahul Sharma, with his experience in manufacturing Micromax smartphones and tablets, seems to have worked out some kind of agreement with the battery manufacturer to repair any damaged cell instead of replacing the battery. Thus, he is the only electric vehicle manufacturer in the world who is willing to give a lifelong warranty even on the battery. Even Elon Musk gives only 8 years warranty for all Tesla cars. 10. Electric vehicles are ugly. Most electric scooters that were manufactured in India were bought in from China. Many of them were plain Jane and had very average looks. If it was parked, one wouldn't even recognize that it is an electric scooter. Nobody could make out the difference between an electric scooter and a petrol scooter on the first glance. Many of them were passed on as classic scooters. Others were downright ugly. Some of them even looked like kids' toys. China manufactured all of these in huge numbers according to the specification given to them by their governments. But their products and its design were at least 20 years old. But with the introduction of Revolt, Rahul Sharma ensured that Revolt has killer looks. It surely is the best looking electric two-wheeler in production today. So hats off to Rahul Sharma. He is truly an electric vehicle guru of this decade. He and Revolt is leading the revolt against petrol vehicles. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys like this video. If you did, please like and share this video, because it will help increase the awareness of electric vehicles. If you have not yet subscribed, then make sure you subscribe and smash the bell icon next to it so that you get notification about our new videos when we post it.